Batman here, with my review of the new Oliver Stone film, W, starring Josh Brolin.
Mr. President, what place do you think you have in history?
In history? I mean, history will all be dead.
You may find yourself in a beautiful house.
Fiasco.
And you may ask yourself, well, how did I get here?
Ruined it for us. The Bush name.
You're my life!
Has he been imbibing something I don't know about?
Yeah, devil. Devil in a white hat.
I'll never get out of Poppy's shadow.
You ever remember the son of the president anyway?
John Quincy Adams.
Yeah, but that was like 300 years ago, wasn't it?
The American people want revenge. They liked Afghanistan. They want more.
Advanced interrogation techniques utilize fear scenarios.
You mean like pulling out their toenails?
My God! What have I done?
Every once in a while, a film comes along that changes cinema history and defies all conventions. This is without doubt not one of those movies. This is one of the worst films I have seen this year. This film is very special for me because I have walked out of two films in my lifetime. Wild Hogs, which do I need a reason to tell you why I walked out of Wild Hogs, and this. Now, I realize I'm a critic and considering the fact I walked out, my opinion might not be valid. I did realize I would have to watch it again, so I acquired it. Not saying how, but I acquired it. And my opinion remains unchanged. One of the few things I can commend about this film is Josh Brolin's performance. He gives a very good one, but the problem with saying that is he's doing a Bush impression. And that's not that hard. I mean, any good comedian can do a Bush impression. As for the rest of the cast, they try their best with what's given to them, Elizabeth Banks especially, but every good cast member this has really nothing to work with, so they just kind of meander around like headless chickens. And also, this film has some really, really terrible casting. For example, Thandie Newton. She looks like Condoleezza Rice, but she sounds like someone trying to do a really bad impression of Condoleezza Rice. And also, she expresses no emotion whatsoever. But the worst bit of casting has got to be James Cromwell. He looks nothing like George W. Sr. and bears little resemblance to Josh Brolin. Why not get James Brolin, Josh Brolin's father? There is a resemblance between the two of them. His father is an Emmy Award winning actor, and under a bit of makeup can easily look like George W. Sr. Stanley Weiser's script for this film is terrible. It's not funny, it's not original, and it's not even Nixon in quality. The jokes are really, really poor. I mean, it's just pointing him and going, hey, isn't that guy such an idiot? Let's just make really easy jabs at a guy who can't defend himself. It's just not funny at all. And it's designed to be funny, but it's not. And some of you may say, oh, it's supposed to be a political satire. If it's a political satire, it's supposed to have comedy in it, not the fact he's an idiot. We have been force-fed that for 8 years. We get it. I don't need an hour and a half reminder of why George W. Bush is an idiot. Oliver Stone is another reason why this movie sucked. He is such a poor director, it's not even funny. I mean, he had a handful of hits back in the 80s and the 90s, but since then he's just been on a downward spiral. Want proof? Check out World Trade Center, which is terrible! And, of course, everyone's favourite, Alexander, which Colin Farrell bounces between Dublin, American, Greek, every accent under the sun. But in this film, his poor direction is just highlighted so well. For example, he over-dramatizes everything. For example, the scene where George W. Bush chokes on a pretzel. He makes it seem as though he's just been shot in the chest. And I don't get this. Are you trying to just go like, Jesus, man, he's choking on a pretzel. He shouldn't be overreacting this badly. Blah, blah, blah. Or are you just really, really bad at directing? Oliver Stone, instead, while making this film, he wanted to make it like The Queen, the Stephen Frears film of 2006, which I would definitely recommend to everyone. And the reason why this film will never be considered at the same level of quality as The Queen is because The Queen took a look at the Queen of England at one of the most difficult points in her life, and it made her a human being. At the point in her life, she was being crucified by the media, and people were basically asking for her head. And Stephen Frears captured the emotional difficulties she had to deal with as well as the public difficulties. What Oliver Stone does here is he looks at George W. Bush as a whole and goes, that guy's an idiot. The media's right, let's just attack him some more. Forget about original ideas or showing him in a real light, let's just attack him. And some have said, oh, it's a sympathetic view. No, it's not. Okay? I did not find any sympathy in from George Bush's character. I just found it as Oliver Stone attacking him with a big rock, which people claim to be sympathy. Another thing which really annoyed me is that Oliver Stone made this film to try and influence voters' decisions. Now, we only got this in Ireland yesterday. So, basically, it has no relevance for us. But what really annoys me is that if this was to affect my decision, I would now vote for McCain. Because I would not want to have to listen to Oliver Stone say, yes, Barack Obama got in because of my excellent movie. Because you know he is. He's saying that to all his friends behind the scenes whilst doing a lot of shrooms. Now, I saw this film with a friend. His name is Ian, and here is his review of it.
God damn this movie!
Thanks, Ian. Fine review there.
Bottom line is, this movie sucks. It's terribly written, horribly acted, poorly directed, and has some of the worst casting in cinema history, in my opinion. It's one of the worst films of this year, and one of the worst films I've seen of all time. I mean, I've seen Big Mom's House too, people. So, I give W, by Oliver Stone, The Fat Man's Thumbs Down.
You suck.